sixth question, we have to find the roots of the equation given by this. So let us try to solve this. So x power 3 by 4 log x base 3 whole square plus 5 by 4 log x base 3 minus 4 is given as 3 cube. So let us take log base 3 on both sides. So it will give us log 3x power this thing 3 by 4 log 3x whole square plus 5 by 4 log 3x minus 4 equal to log 3 base 3 cube. So this power will come in front, so we will get 3 by 4 log x base 3 whole square plus 5 by 4 log x base 3 minus 4 into log x base 3 equal to this 3 will also come in front. So we'll get log 3 base 3 which is 1 and we'll get 3. So basically we are getting 3 by 4 log 3 x whole square plus 5 by 4 log x base 3 minus 4 whole into log 3 base x equal to 3. So now let us assume t equal to log 3 x. So let us substitute t here in log x base 3. So we will get 3 by 4 t square plus 5 by 4 t minus 4 into t equal to 3. So if we simplify this, we will get 3 by 4 t cube plus 5 by 4 t square minus 4 t equal to 3. So if we multiply 4 on both sides, we will get 3 t cube plus 5 t square minus 16 t, and 3 into 4 is 12, and if we take 12 on this side, we will get minus 12, that is equal to 0. Now if we use trial and error method, I mean heat and trial method, you can say, so if we put t equal to 2 in this polynomial, you will get 0. So t equal to 2 will be a root. So t minus 2 will be a factor of it. So if we take t minus 2 out, we will get the other factor to be 3t square plus 11t plus 6. That is equal to 0. And again, if you factorize this quadratic, you will get t plus 3 into 3t plus 2. So I want all of you to verify these two steps at your own time. So we will get 3 roots, t equal to 2, minus 3 and minus 2 by 3. Now what is t? T is log x base 3. So this is 2. So our x will be 3 square. So for the other two cases we will get x will be 3 power minus 3. And for the last case we will get x equal to 3 power minus 2 by 3. So the roots are 3 square, 3 power minus 3 and 3 power minus 2 by 3. Thank you.